day won't stay wise. Let the children hear when the cry. Okay, what's up? We're back. I'm wearing the same thing. It's only been like 30 minutes for me. But what's up, guys? Brent Fechter here. And the reason that we are here, as well, why the fuck would any of you know? As nobody knows, not even me. No, of course, we're talking about Survivor Season 40. You guys, I'm really excited for Survivor Season 40. I'm a modern Survivor super fan. I love this shit. I did a talk about the Red Tribe before. Now I'm going to talk about the Blue Tribe. And honestly, I had some notes on the other video. And for this video, I kind of just didn't feel like writing anything down anymore. So, I'm just gonna do this shit on the fly, and God, wouldn't it be wild if this turned out to be the better video? I don't know, neither one would probably be much good. But anyway, the first person that I want to talk about on the Blue Tribe of Survivor Season 40 is the person who I think will be, who was my winner pick until I switched it to my girl Michelle Fitzgerald. Would you excuse me a moment? Perfect. Thank you for your service. All right. But I changed it to Michelle, but I think Tyson could win too. Okay? He's my other winner pick. He's my winner pick from this tribe. I mean, Michelle's my overall winner pick, but Tyson could do it. He's going to have his pick of the litter. He will be the one calling the shots. He's the only one with the power to save Amber. I'll tell you that much, which he very well may do because of his friendship with Rob. If this tribe goes to tribal twice, I think Amber's probably done then. But I think that Tyson will protect her initially. And I think that nobody will be against Tyson in the beginning. I think he has Sandra. I think Sandra has Tony. So, and I heard Sesternino saying that Tyson's not a huge Tony fan. He feels overshadowed by Tony, but I think Tyson's smart enough to know that he needs shields, at least at first. So, you know what I see him doing is probably cutting Tony at the knees by taking out Officer Sarah. But Tyson is going far in this game, very far. I do think Michelle will win, but Tyson has a shot. Another one besides Tony, whose fate Tyson will be deciding in the early days of this game, probably, is Wendell. So, apparently, I heard on Johnny Fairplay, who I didn't always love Johnny Fairplay, but I admit he grew on me. It was an acquired taste. I like Fairplay now. So, apparently, Tyson said somewhere in his pregame that he was looking at Wendell. Wendell was one of the guys who he wasn't getting the great eyes from. And he said Wendell was walking around Ponderosa with a journal. And Tyson said that Wendell has the beginning of the game to make him change his mind. And if Wendell doesn't change Tyson's mind about Wendell, Tyson is going to go to everybody else and say, hey, you know that journal Wendell was walking around with in pregame? Yeah, I saw over his shoulder one day. It was a boot list. Your name was first, your name was second, your name was third. Oh, Wendell, I hope Tyson likes you, man, because Tyson is going to be running shit here. I think he's going to pull Nick and Yule. I think he's going to have, like I said, Sandra and Amber, and I believe Kim. I just think that he's calling the shots, bottom line. Alright, next let's talk about Sandra Diaz-Twine. She is the only two-time winner. She will most likely not be a three-time winner, guys, come on. I mean, she is the one who's entering the game with the second biggest target on her back. She also had a statue out there. And apparently, She's super mad at Rob for them spending season 39 together and him not mentioning once that not only will he be returning for season 40, but his wife will be as well. So take that for what it's worth, but the Queen is none too happy. However, I think in the early days, the Queen is not going to be in trouble because she is going to link up with Godfather Tyson and she'll make some, we'll have some fun, entertaining moments from Sandra Diaz Twine. You can bet on that. How do I see her placing? I see her placing about the same as she placed in Game Changers. That is what I'll say for that. Next, let's move on to my man, Wendell Holland. And like I was just saying about how what I heard from Fairplay that Tyson was saying about Wendell, I had a bad feeling. I happen to agree with my man Phil from Phil and Alexa, who I love, the Survivor Specialist. Love those two. Phil was saying he couldn't forget about how the beginning of Wendell's last time he played, he got blindsided, Morgan went home. It could just as easily have been Wendell, though, and he might have gone out third. And here I could see Tyson calling an early hit on Wendell. However, I think Wendell is a strong chance of returning from Edge, if a man returns from Edge, which I think a woman will, and I'll talk about that in a minute. But if Wendell's an early boot, like I fear, what I want is for Wendell to do really well. I would love for Wendell and Yule and Nick and just all the awesome people and Kim and Sandra and the great, awesome people who I'm looking at here. I would love for them to just run the day. But, you know, there's the Tonys and the Tysons of the world, who I love as well, who are going to, you know, be the alpha dogs. I just think that I'm looking at him right now. There's just one too many alpha dogs out there, and Wendell might be the first one to get sniped. And I hate to say it. I hate to see it. And I hope I am wrong. Next, Kim Spradlin. Kim Spradlin will do well. She will not go the distance, but she will be in the endgame. And I'll tell you why. Because Kim Spradlin is going to be the one to come back from Edge. I said it in my prop bet with the Specialist. I'm saying it here. It's going to be Kim. It's going to be Kim. Like, she, Kim is the shit. I think she'll be the second one to come back. She'll probably get voted out at that point. But if she's in the final three, she won't win just because these winners aren't going to want to vote for somebody who got voted out. But I don't think she'll get voted out until, like, ninth. I think that it'll just be one of those things where at a certain point they're like, oh my god, guys, Kim's still here, you know? Kind of similar to, I don't know if she's going to stick with, I don't know. I said in my last video, I see the merge culminating with a Tyson-Parvati war. And I think that Tyson's going to scoop up Ethan, who won't have Rob anymore. And now here's where I see the division happening, because I think initially Kim will work with Tyson. But then, and I think initially Parvati will work with Ethan. But then when this switch happens, I kind of feel like maybe Kim and Parvati will get together and Ethan and Tyson will get together. But I don't know. Eventually Kim's going to get picked off. But like I said, I really think she's going to come back. I think they want a female to return from Edge. And I think that a female certainly will return from Edge one of the times, if not both. Okay, that's all I got to say about that. Next, I would like to talk about my favorite player in the history. Well, no. Okay. My second favorite player in the history of Survivor. And he's actually only my second favorite player on his season, because Angelina Keeley was on his season. But Nick Wilson, who I think is just... It's my David vs. Goliath is my favorite season, okay? I love Nick, man. He just had that Kentucky charm. I was hearing on Rob has a podcast that none of them think Nick is going to do well when they had that roundtable discussion. My man, Nick always finds a way. Okay, let me tell you. In the David tribe, he was in trouble with the first boot. He was about to be the first boot. God saved him with a storm that took out Pat, poor Pat. But honestly, I think we were way better off with Nick on that season. I love Nick. I think Nick is once again going to his southern charm is going to carry him deep, not all the way to the end, but he will be, you know, part of Tyson's army. He will be a high-ranking official here. He will make noise. He will make splashy moves. Nick Wilson plays Survivor hard. And who knows? He could be pre-merged because of that, but I don't think he is. I think Nick is going to go to at least final seven. Okay, next I'm going to talk about Sophie Clark. Honestly, I think Sophie's the weakest player on this tribe. Yes. I don't know. I didn't see Amber's season, so. But I saw everybody else's season, except for Amber and Yule. Sorry, super fans. I guess I gotta go back and watch those seasons. But Yule, I've heard a lot. But let's get back to Sophie. Sophie beat Coach. A lot of people think Coach should have won. It's kind of a Russell and Natalie type situation. You know, Sophie got voted for because people just couldn't freaking stand Coach at that point. I don't think that, you know, she's all over the podcast talking all this strategy. I don't think she's going to do well in this season, guys. I think that she is an early boot. I think that she is one of these players that they're just going to, not in the very beginning, because why waste a vote on Sophie in the very beginning, right? But I think that, you know, she's one of these people who's likely to be swap screwed. You know, I don't know what kind of connections really many, if any, of these people have coming in, besides, you know, people who played together, like Sandra, Tony, and Sarah. But I don't see Sophie doing too well. I see her being the Chelsea Townsend of this season. At best. I mean, Chelsea got robbed in the edit. She did some stuff. She did a lot more than Chelsea from 39. But I don't know if Sophie is going to do as much as either one of those lovely ladies. Anyway, next, why don't we talk about the mythical beast himself, the unicorn, Tony Vlachos. Everybody thinks that Tony is fucked. Let me tell you something. I think Tony is going to do some stuff this year. I think that he's not coming in hot like Game Changers, where he's like running through the jungle looking for idols. He's not going to piss off Sandra. He and Sandra know they have to bury this hatchet. They have to know that. In fact, I know that they know that. I'm sure of it. So unless he dumbly pisses her off like he did in Game Changers, he's not going to get sniped right away. Unless Tyson wants him to be sniped right away. Now, this is a caveat for everybody on this tribe. If Tyson wants them gone in the beginning, they're gone in the beginning. But I don't think that Tyson's going to want Tony gone in the very beginning. And I think that that they want Tony to make some noise. And he will make some noise. I hope he's not going to be pre-merge. I don't think he's going to be pre-merge. I honestly feel like he's going to be early merge. And then probably not win his way back in. But I think we are not done. I think we're only a little bit more than halfway of the Best of Tony Vlachos video that will one day be getting made. And hey, if he plays a fourth time, maybe we're only a quarter of the way there. Hope he does. Okay, so next, let's talk about the last two I'm going to talk about are the two I know the least about. But I know a little bit more about Amber, because I know that she is, again, wait, is her husband on this season? Yes, okay, both the Marianos are on this season. I know that it is said that he carried her through the season she won, I think back then, you know, people cared more about honor and integrity than they did about gameplay. You know, like, it wasn't a Tony and Wu situation with Rob and Amber, well, obviously. But the biggest thing working against Amber is the fact that Rob is in this game, and Rob is Rob, and Rob has this fucking three-story statue that they had to drive by, and Rob pissed off Sandra by not telling her, and so Sandra's gonna want to target Amber right away. The only thing that can save Amber from being an early, early boot is Tyson. And I think that he could save her, and probably will save her. And the only chance she has to not be a pre-merge boot is if Rob goes right away. But as I explained in the other video, I don't think Rob's going right away. I see Amber being the pre-merge boot, and I see her quitting Edge of Extinction if she goes to it early. I'm sorry to say that, but it's just the way I see it panning out. Anyway, last but not least, we have Yul Kwan. Now, I have studied a lot about his Yul Kwan's game. I have not watched his entire season. I know he beat Ozzy, so he was the godfather, right? He was the strategic beast. He was the mastermind. The problem is with Yul coming into this season, from what I've heard, is that he doesn't have a lot of connections to the other players on this cast. Now, he played with Parvati, but she's on the other tribe, and from the look on her face when she saw him, they haven't been keeping in touch, let's just say. But you know what? I think that Yul is likable to the point where, kind of like with Nick, I see them as like a kind of yin and a yang. I would love for Nick and Yul to kind of team up here, and I think that they could. I think they could be two top dogs in Tyson's alliance. Hell, maybe if they put their brains together, they could even take Tyson out. Anything could happen. I mean, shit, I don't know anything. Like, I'm just literally taking shots in the dark with everything here. But, I don't know. He could also be seen as a super threat and be an early boot. Like I'm saying, it all depends on what Tyson wants to do here. But, I think Yul will make the swap, and he will make the merge, and he will go home around 11th place. Okay, I'll put him at 11th, because that's where I put Jeremy potentially playing his idol correctly. And maybe Yul will be the one who gets idled out there. Okay, boom, there. There's a crazy prediction. All right, I think I did everybody, right? All 10. So that is the blue tribe. I hope I didn't fuck these colors up. And I hope that some of you guys enjoyed listening to me just talk about Survivor Season 40, because Survivor Season 40 is going to be epic, you guys. It is going to be epic. Like, we got players like Wendell who, you know, he was great in his season, and Tony was amazing in his season, and Nick controlled the entire game. Kim controlled the entire game. Well, Nick didn't control the entire game, but he maneuvered through the entire game. Kim controlled her entire game. Tyson controlled his entire winning game. Officer Sarah, did I talk about her yet? Maybe I did. Whoa. My girl Sarah. Let's not forget Sarah here. Did I specifically go into Sarah? I'm not entirely sure. Okay. Sarah. Officer Sarah Lacina. I think she is going to be an early boot. Not super early, but pre-merge. I say that just because I'm hearing a lot of talk about how a lot of people are gunning for her. I think she's walking around feeling like she's hot shit. I think she might try to stab Sandra too soon, and that's not going to fly with King Tyson. I don't know that, but I think that might happen. Again, like I said, I think maybe Sarah goes because Tyson wants Tony, but he wants Tony in a more weakened state. kind of like the way I feel that Natalie Anderson's going to get picked off because people want Jeremy, but, you know, they want to be Jeremy's friend and ally. Sarah, she better bring it. She can talk the talk. Let's see. And she can walk the walk as well, which is why she's such a huge target. Just like, you know, she won an all-returning player season. Those are the people to draw to. Those are the people that are going to get looked at. And that's just the way it is. So, we shall see. But I don't feel great about Sarah's chances here. I think my favorite player on this tribe is Nick Wilson. Second favorite is maybe between Tony, Wendell, and Sandra. But like I said, I think this is Tyson's tribe to lose. Maybe game to lose. Hey, we'll see. It's either going to be him or Michelle Fitzgerald. Listen, guys, thank you so much for any of you who did happen to watch this. I've really been passionate about Survivor in the past few years. And, you know, I feel like I'm a modern Survivor super fan. So I'm excited about Winners at War, and it's going to be a hell of a ride. I'm going to try and keep doing these. We'll see what happens, where it goes from here. But get hype, you guys. God bless you guys. Like, come on, man. Let's keep the dream alive, all right?
One.
What about the outro music this time?